Can't believe it. The water temperature is 76 degrees. This is the, you know, you say late February, that's in the mid of winter. That's when everything's the coldest of the cold. They're supposed to be 76 degree water temperature. So very, very mild winter. And that's what we're going to talk about today is our importance of water temperature and temperature around the earth. And it doesn't seem like a lot, but it's going to determine where all the fish are and how they act. And that's going to really determine where the dolphins are going to go, because they're always looking for the fish, you know, 25 pounds of fish a day. So that's really going to be an important factor. So 76 degrees, 2 years ago, it was about 55 degrees here. So over a 20 degree difference from 2 years ago at this time to now. So how will that affect all the animals? Well, let's pick one in particular, say the manatee. The manatee is the sea cow, the big kind of slow moving guy in the waters here, and he's really huge. So you would think that he would be okay with cold water, but actually it's just the opposite. So we know our dolphins have blubber. I know you guys have heard of blubber. And all whales and dolphins, all of our cetaceans, are going to have a layer of blubber. Some are thinner, some are really thick in some of the whales. But this blubber is this specialized fat, this really, really dense fat that holds their body temperature in. So when the water gets really, really cold, they're able to survive. And they have other ways to keep their heat to the center of their body, around all their organs and away from their fins and things like that. So a dolphin, a bottlenose dolphin, can go down to about 40 degrees water temperature. And to give you an idea how cold that is, 32 degrees is freezing. So if we put water and get it down to 32 degrees, it'll turn into an ice cube. It'll freeze up into ice. So 40 degrees isn't much warmer than that. The adult dolphins can be swimming around in that water temperature without being stressed at all. So they can go all the way down to 40. Then on the other end, in the summertime here, the water temperature can get up to, we've seen 93 degrees. 93, I mean, that's really, really hot. I mean, our body temperature is 98, and that keeps all of our blood warm inside of us, so getting close to that. So there's this wide range, over 50 degrees, that the dolphins can survive in pretty comfortably. You know, once it gets up to the 90s, you know, it's gonna be like us. You know, when it's summertime and it's really hot outside, we don't go outside and do as much running and playing as we would in the fall and spring when it's nice and mild. So the dolphins do the same thing. When it's August or September and the water's really, really hot, they're going to kind of slow down and not be quite as playful as they would normally, that we'll see. Now back to the other animals in the water. So right now, in February, we would never see a manatee in these waters. It would normally be too cold. And the manatee is not as tolerant to the cold temperatures. 68 degrees, which is pretty mild. If they get into water 68 or lower, they start shivering. They can actually die of hypothermia. They have to go and find warmer water right away, or they can freeze. Well, at this time in winter, we would be way below 68. So we'd never see a manatee out here. They would be crazy to be out here because they would be freezing. But this year, we've been seeing them pretty regularly. Every week or so, we're having a sighting of a mom and a calf or a group of manatees. So showing how just from that change of water temperature, being not as cold of a winter, is changing the manatees' entire patterns, where they're able to use these waters to find grass to eat and other things, to places to travel, where normally in a February here, they wouldn't be able to use these waters. They would be restricted to the warmer waters that would be further inland, where natural warm water comes up from the ground, natural warm springs, where the manatees will hang out there for the whole entire winter time. And same thing with fish. A lot of these fish are tropical type fish or subtropical. So tropical is like right near the equator, the rainforests and all those things. Subtropical is a little off the rainforest like we are, where it's still nice and warm. You get a lot of different species and life, but not quite as hot, as much sun and rain as we'll see like in the rainforest. But a lot of the fish here, they're made for this warm water. So if we get a really cold winter, it could actually change the patterns of the fish or even kill a lot of fish. And 2 winters ago, we had thousands and thousands of fish die and hundreds of manatees die just because we had a really cold winter. So we see just in 2 years, extreme cold winter for Florida. And now 2 years later, extreme warm winter in Florida. So it shows you that there's a really imbalance. You know, if there was a balance, it would fluctuate, but not so much. And one of the things is it's a thing called global warming. And you guys might have heard of it. It's kind of a stretch to understand. It's mainly caused by man-made things like. You losing me? Can you hear me? Can you hear me? No. Okay, let me try to call you back.